Vatra suno sandena kut. Tanos teva pertu adat. Krus teva adam. Ritam usha ve asiate fontane. Nesco aia.
T.E. Lawrence, eponymously of Arabia, but very much an Englishman, favored pinching a burning match between his fingers to put it out. When asked by his colleague, William Potter, to reveal his trick, how is it he so effectively extinguished the flame without hurting himself whatsoever, Lawrence just smiled and said, "The trick, Potter, is not minding it hurts." The fire that danced at the end of that match was a gift from the Titan Prometheus, a gift that he stole from the gods, who were terrified of what we might do with it were it to fall into our hairy little paws. When Prometheus was caught and brought to justice for his theft, the gods, well, you might say they overreacted a little. The poor man was tied to a rock as an eagle ripped through his belly and ate his liver over and over, day after day, ad infinitum. All because he gave us fire, our first true piece of technology. Fire. Such a very long time ago. Which begs the question, what have we done with it? 100,000 BC, stone tools. 4,000 BC, the wheel. 800 BC, sundial. 9th century AD, gunpowder. Bit of a game changer, that one.
1441, the printing press. Only slightly less impactful.
19th century, steam engine, railway. Eureka, the light bulb. 20th century, the automobile, television, nuclear weapons, spacecraft, internet. 21st century, biotech, nanotech, fusion and fission and M theory. And that was just the first decade. We are now 3 months into the year of our Lord, 2023. At this moment in our civilization, we are on the verge of terraforming planets undiscovered just a decade ago. We have identified the genetic chain of events behind 98% of cancers. A chain we have broken, effectively curing them. We can create cybernetic individuals who, in just a few short years, will be completely indistinguishable from us. Which leads to an obvious conclusion. We are the gods now. haven't been struck down. I'll take that to mean I'm right. We wield incredible power. The power to transform, to destroy, and to create again. The question, of course, before us is what the hell are we supposed to do with this power? Or more importantly, one should ask, what are we allowed to do with this power? The answer to that, my friends, is nothing. Rules, restrictions, laws, ethical guidelines, all but forbidding us from moving forward. Well, where were the ethics during the Arabian conflicts? Why are rules preventing us from feeding impoverished cultures? How is there a law that states if we build a man from wires and metal, a man who will never grow old, who will never feel the heat of a star or the cold of the moon, how is the creation of such an incredible individual considered unnatural? The answer to all these questions is simple. These rules exist because the people who created them were afraid of what would happen if they didn't. Well, I am not afraid. For those of you who know me, you will be aware by now that my ambition is unlimited. You know that I will settle for nothing short of greatness, or I will die trying. For those of you who do not yet know me, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Peter Weyland. And if you'll indulge me, I'd like to change the world.
Hello, Mr. Weyland.
Hello.
I'm Dr. Elizabeth Shaw. If that name sounds familiar to you, it's because I've been calling your office every day for the last month, trying to get a meeting.
I think your people were hoping I'd give up. I'm not good at giving up. What I am good at is my job. I'm an archaeologist. I have doctorates in paleontology, archaeology, human ethology, and memetics, all of which I received from Oxford. I graduated first in my class at the age of 17. This is not who I am. It's simply what I know. I make the distinction, sir, because there's the difference in what a scientist knows and what they believe. That difference is proof. Do you feel that all the science in the world will never give us the answers we really want? What happens when we die? What our purpose is? Where we came from? Whether or not we are truly alone? I believe there is a place where every one of those questions could be answered. I believe I know where that place is. I need you to get me there. Give me 10 minutes of your time. 10 minutes to let me show you what I found. And if you put your faith in me, Mr. Weyland, no one will ever feel alone again. If you don't respond, sir, I completely understand, but I'll be sending this transmission again tomorrow. Thank you.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Guys? Oh my God. Oh my God.
Baby, you're gonna want to see this.
Look at this. Look at this beautiful thing.
In all the systems we've ever cataloged, we have never found anything larger than bacteria. But this is life. We found life.
Come here, baby. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Our first alien.
I guess we're really lucky we brought you, Milburn Biology.
A woman in Africa told me the story of how the world came to be. She said, first there was a sun, but it had no one to shine on. So the sun made man. And man looked up at the sun and asked, why did you make me? And the sun said, because I was alone. My whole life I've been looking for what we found today. We're not alone anymore. Cheers.
Cheers.
I can't see you, but I know you can hear me, you tin can. Now report.
Yes, Miss Vickers.
Better get your ass back here right now. These idiots are about to infect my ship.
Of course, right away. I do apologize. Technical difficulties.
Have you located your objective, David?
I believe I have. It's time.
Are you here to file a report?
No. I'm not.
I'm really not in the mood for coffee.
It's a good thing it's rum, then. There you go.
Please don't touch that.
You know, before I sold my soul to corporate, I was in the military. Yeah. Before I did that, though, I was flying sorties out of Jordan. And this one base I was on had this building. No windows, pure steel, surrounded by a barbed wire fence. I see small men in white coats running in and out of it. We knew they were making something in there, and we knew it was bad. Anyway, one night, the alarm goes, and we get ordered to do a full evac, everybody out. And I'm running towards my transport, and I see these men in white coats trying to get out that building, screaming, crying for their lives. Turns out that fence wanted to keep us out. Just to keep them in. Anyway, we get in the air and I see my CO flip open a box that he had on his lap, had a gray button on it, and he closes his eyes and he starts to pray. And then 6 kilometers out, he decides to push that button. And even that far out, we felt the heat of that explosion as 1,100 souls, give or take, vaporized just because some idiot spilled something. Now, I know it was a long time ago, but I feel the same thing happened here. Those things, those engineers, they made something they shouldn't have. And they spilled it. It was your turn to push the button.
Why did you decide to tell me that story now?
Because you killed a man today. Looks like you're in pain.
I burned my hand.
What the hell was that, Jazz?
Boss, we're getting seismic activity.
From where?
Below ground, about one click east.
Yeah, he's right. We're getting heat signatures, same place.
Hey, do you want to tell me what the hell was going on?
Not particularly. Is he awake?
Almost.
Is who awake?
That's not really your concern, Captain. Now, if you could please make sure the rovers are ready to roll within the hour, we'd appreciate it.
Hey, hey! Hey!
Tell him why I came.
Yidach, manamai. Yana murtu steda. Uiva, on itam sostatar kreda.
You see this man? My company built him from nothing. I made him. And I made him in my own image so that he would be perfect. So that he would never fail. I deserve this. Because you and I, we are superior. We are creators. We are gods. And gods never die.
Elizabeth, can you hear me? What is it about robots that makes them so robotic? At Wayland Industries, it has long been our goal to create artificial intelligence almost indistinguishable from mankind itself. Hello, I'm David.
What can you do, David?
I can do almost anything that could possibly be asked of me. I can assist your employees. I can make your organization more efficient. I can carry out directives that my human counterparts might find distressing or unethical. I can blend in with your workforce effortlessly.
David, what do you think about?
I think about anything. Children playing. Angels. The universe. Robots.
David, what makes you sad?
cruelty. Unnecessary violence. I understand human emotions, although I do not feel them myself. This allows me to be more efficient and capable, and makes it easier for my human counterparts to interact with me.
Is there anything you would like to say, David?
I would like to express gratitude to those who created me. Happy birthday, David. From Wayland Industries. Eighth generation Wayland type. Technological, intellectual, physical, emotional.
How long you gotta stand there like that?
Can we have a name, please?
Captain.
And your blood type?
I don't know.
Could you lend the service?
Way too long. I don't like that. Take that off me, please.
So how tall are you, Captain Yannick? Captain, you can't smoke in here, Captain Yannick.
Charlie Holloway.
And what's your length of service, Dr. Holloway?
I did 3 tours, one on Mars, one on Earth, and this is my first intergalactic mission.
And your height, please?
6. No, I'm just kidding. It's 5'11". I wish it was 6.
State Chair. Maker unknown. Holland, circa 1760. Teapot, lapis lazuli, Ettore Sottsass, Italy, 1972. Dressing table. Armand Albert Rateau, France, circa 1925. Mr. and Mrs. Andrews, Thomas Gainsborough, England, 1749. Glass chair, Shiro Kurumata, Japan,
1960. Name, please?
My name is David.
And what's your mission role, David?
To care for the crew.
Okay. And what's your mission role, Dr. Shaw?
I'm the leader of this scientific expedition.
And your length of service?
This is my first mission. If this transmission has found you, if we have found you, on behalf of everyone, I would like to say hello. I've been dreaming about you as long as I can remember. We want to see you. We need to see you. We are coming now.
What do I hope to get out of this mission?
Yeah.
Everything. I want to crush all man-made religions and prove everybody wrong.
Ryoka. Nothing.
Как самочувствие? Сколько пальцев?
Good.